Let's move to Limpopo now, where that province accounts for 1% of the coronavirus statistics nationally. Annually, December approves, or it proves to be a time where people visit the province for festive season. Well, while some go on planned tours, for example, to Limpopo, but this year plans are being dealt a blow by the coronavirus pandemic and the health protocols, which may force people to adhere to. Well, that's where we find our reporter, Pelane Phakgadi. He is in Pietersburg, Pietersburg Hospital. And I'm told, Pelane, you have the MEC of Health in that province. How are things going there as far as observing COVID-19 regulations?
Well, colleague, myself and the MEC are currently observing our not only our meter distance among between one another, but we have our masks on, of which is the standard practice that we should be engaging in. But I just want to bring along the MEC into our conversation, a detailed one. MEC Phophi Ramathuba, thank you very much for joining us here on Newzroom Africa. Earlier on today, we were talking to the transport department. They were indicating possibilities or indications of a partnership, as in all ports of entries within the province in itself. There will be screening, adequate screening, to ensure that people who are moving to the province, at least their temperatures are okay. Will that assist in the fight against COVID?
Thank you very much, and good morning, and morning to the viewers out there. Yes, indeed, we have agreed, and as the Provincial Command Council, that we must have joint efforts, not only the Department of Community Safety and Transport, but also including other departments like your tourism, economic development. Also, there will be having quite a number of activities that we will be on the road, especially our main, the N1. We want, just as the Department of Health, screening for COVID-19 only, but also while the Department of Transport will be screening your vehicle for roadworthiness, we will also screen you as a driver if you are roadworthy, because some of our drivers don't even know that they've got non-communicable diseases. They are diabetic, they are hypertensive, they don't know. And those conditions causes them to have fatigue, blurred vision. That's why you see many accidents that we see on our roads. So as a Department of Health, what we'll be doing is that we'll be screening you. If we find you to be, your blood sugar being elevated, unfortunately you will not proceed with your trip. We'll have to take you to our facility so that we start you with a treatment. Until such time, when we have stabilized you, you can be able to proceed, because these are silent killers. And secondly, we will not only be screening you for the temperature, but also we will be giving messages, because it's important for people to understand that as you are leaving Gauteng or Eastern Cape or any part of the country, you are entering Limpopo, you might not even be symptomatic, because you are young, you are healthy, you are still active, that's why you are working there. But you might be COVID positive, not symptomatic, not even your test results might even show you that they are negative. So we need to emphasize that message. So as you enter, you get to the province and you get to your village, stay away from your parents who are old and vulnerable. Make sure you are wearing your mask. Don't come closer to the granny. Don't come closer to the aunt, because you will celebrate this festive season with them. Come January, we might be talking a different language when you are left alone as a member of that family and the whole family member being wiped out of COVID. So that's why we will be doing those messages, and we'll also at the same time advising to say, is it worth it now, these family gatherings that we want to aritsibaneng? We are saying we will do our aritsibaneng in the next year, when we would be having probably a vaccine, or we would have made strides in terms of the fighting COVID. For now, let's avoid all those.
While we're still on that one, earlier on the year when COVID was still, we were still unsure about how it goes, the symptoms of it, there was still little information about it. You had called on people perhaps to just stay in their regions, their provinces. Will this still be the case? Will that you still be making that kind of a call to say, is it necessary as well to travel to your home provinces?
I will still advise. I'll still advise to say we are on a second wave. While at least the difference between March and now is that we understand the virus now. We've got a bit of knowing how can we protect ourselves, but we are on a second wave. The minister has already declared some provinces have taken the country into the second wave currently. So we are saying you might be coming from the area where you are young. That is the most important message that people must understand, that when you are young, you will be infected and be highly infectious, but not even knowing that, because your immune system is able to fight and suppress that particular virus and you are not getting sick. However, you will get to the province, get to your family, infect them. So I will still make that call. I will still, it will be for the first time that I will spend the entire festive season without even greeting my mother, but talking to her telephonically, because I don't know. You can see I'm here in the hospital currently. We are busy trying with the clinical director here to try to check our state of readiness. But we are also saying, in the meantime, I might get infected and not be symptomatic, not even know. Go to talk to my mother, hug her, infect her. Will she survive it? No, because she's old.
Talk to me about, as we close now, that state of readiness, not only Pietersburg Hospital, across the hospitals all in all your districts. What is your readiness for not only the festive, but as well as should there be a number of high COVID cases in the province?
We can reassure the people of South Africa, the people of Limpopo, that we are ready. All our facilities, 43 of them, there is no facility that doesn't have a ward which is dedicated to deal with COVID-19. Even our district hospital now, we have now equipped them with high-flow oxygen machine so that they can be able to assist patients who will be require supportive ventilation. In this particular hospital, we even have got an ICU dedicated to deal with COVID-19, but we also have got other wards that are dedicated for patients who would be requiring admission. We also have our medullary MDR. You remember earlier on in the year when we were preparing for the first wave, we make sure that we've got 87 beds that are equipped with ventilators and high flow oxygen equipment, and those beds will be there to admit. But however, I must warn the public. Infrastructure, we are ready. Equipment, we are ready. But are we ready when it comes to our personnel? People must deal with the reality to say, you are talking about the nurses and the doctors and the porters and the cleaners who have never been on a level 5 lockdown. They've been on duty from March up until today. They have never had a holiday. They've never had a weekend off. They've been working throughout. So currently, the biggest challenge that we have is that our staff is exhausted. Some of them are even getting infected now. So that is why we're working with public Department of Community Safety and Transport, because the more you get more accident, you are again overburdening the very same few healthcare workers. So we are calling upon our people to say, can they really help us to protect each other? We don't want a lot of admissions.
MEC Phophi Ramathuba, such a very strong call there, Koli. You can just hear health personnel are exhausted and calling all people to adhere to the COVID-19 regulations. Back to you, Koli.
All right. Thank you very much there, Pelane Phakgadi.